Hello everybody, I'm John Riddle, and today we've got another great tutorial for you. If you've ever wanted to know how to use Photoshop Elements by Adobe, you've come to the right place, because we're going to show you right now. Now, Photoshop Elements for 2025 is a complete photo editor. It's designed for both beginners and amateurs. It works on Windows and Mac OS, and it's part of the Adobe Elements bundle, which is under a 3-year license. We're going to show you everything you need to know to begin using this great software. Let's get started right now. Once you open Photoshop Elements, the home screen appears with a search bar at the top and quick links on the right to open Adobe Organizer to manage your photo collections and Premiere Elements as video editor. To know more about Premiere Elements, make sure to check our dedicated tutorial on it. To start editing with Photoshop Elements, click on Photo Editor to start with a new project or open any recent PSD project you have. As the interface opens, this is light by default, but you can switch to a dark mode by going to Edit, Preferences, General. First of all, let's import some photos. You can drag and drop them directly into the workspace, or you can click the Open button in the top left corner to browse for your files. All these images are listed in the Photo Bin panel at the bottom, where you can click on any image to preview it. You can zoom in or out by holding the Alt or the Option key while using your mouse wheel. To pan around the image, simply hold the spacebar key and drag. At this point, select the proper workspace from the top. Quick for simple edits, Guided for step-by-step modifications, and Advanced for a more detailed and expert touch. Let's start with the Quick workspace. At the bottom, you get several buttons, such as Rotate to rotate the image by 90 degrees, the Undo and the Redo buttons to go back and forth through your actions, and Organizer to open Adobe Organizer. Click on Home Screen to come back to the Startup page. On the left side, you get the Toolbar, where you can select any tool and customize its options with the Tool Options panel at the bottom. With the Straighten tool, you can click and drag across the photo to align it with automatic crop if needed. Switch to the Crop tool to crop the image. Click and drag to move the grid, resize it by dragging its nodes, keeping the same aspect ratio with the Shift key down. You can also rotate the crop by dragging outside the grid. Use Commit to apply the crop or Cancel to undo. Photoshop Elements offers several tools for portraits. Use the Red Eye tool to remove red eyes by clicking and dragging over these, making sure to cover the eye completely for the best result. Enable the Whiten Teeth tool to click and brush over teeth to brighten these. To improve portraits, switch to the Guided workspace and go to Special Edits, Perfect Portrait. Here you can smooth skin, adjust facial features, and much more with the help of AI. Enable the Remove tool for more advanced corrections, selecting the tool type from the tool options at the bottom. The Remove tool allows you to brush over imperfections to correct them. Use the Spot Healing brush to fix small spots by clicking once. Enable the Healing Brush tool to apply larger and complex corrections. Hold the Alt or the Option key and click to set a reference source point. Then brush over the area you want to correct, pasting pixels from the source point. You can also adjust the blending mode or be aligned with the source point if you need. To add text, enable the Type tool. Click and drag to drop a text box and type in. If the text is not visible, make sure to enlarge the text box enough. Select text to edit its properties, including font, size, and color from the tool options at the bottom. Applying modifications with commit. Switch to the text on shape tool to click and drag to drop a shape. Then type along it by clicking anywhere on the shape border. Make sure to resize text if this does not fit properly. Enable the text on custom path tool to draw a freehand path. Apply it and then type along the curve. Enable the Move tool to manage text properly. Click and drag to move text, resize it using the nodes, and rotate it by dragging from outside. If you need to edit the text content itself, just double-click on it. On the right side of the interface, you get several panels to make more advanced adjustments. From the Quick Actions panel, you can make fast adjustments like color corrections or dehaze with a single click. You can also add blue sky, colorize black and white photos, add motion effects, or adjust any background or subject. Open the Adjustment panel for more corrections. On Exposure and Lighting, adjust brightness and exposure through regions like shadows, midtones, and highlights. On Color, adjust color intensity with saturation, color range with hue and vibrance, and use temperature and tint to apply color filters. Use Sharpen to reduce blurriness instead. While making these changes, switch to the View mode from the top left corner of the screen, comparing the original image before with the edited one after. Open the Effects panel to apply effects between Artistic, Classic, and Color Match by clicking on any template you like. You can also open the Enhance tab to apply other effects, such as moving elements. Through the step-by-step instructions on the right, you can add motion to selected areas of your photo and preview the result. This can be exported as an MP4 video file to share. Now let's see the selection tools. By default, adjustments and brush tools affect the entire image, unless you have any selected region. Enable the selection tools by clicking on the third tool down on the left, then choose the tool type from the tool options. The quick selection tool allows you to select a region by clicking and dragging over the photo. The selection brush tool lets you brush and refine the selection in more detail. With the Auto Selection tool, you can select any subject automatically by dropping a box around it. Enable the Type Mask tools to select areas in the shape of text. To refine selections, hold down the Alt or the Option key to subtract parts. To clear any selection, just press the Escape key. You can also go to the Select tab to automatically select any subject, sky, or background, saving you time and effort. Now let's switch to the Advanced Workspace. It's very useful when you need to work with layers. Layers are the various elements that come together on your canvas, like images, text, and adjustments, as you can check from the Layers panel on the right. The original image is called Background, while any corrections made on the Quick Workspace may appear as other layers above it. You can hide or show any layer with the eye icon and drag any layer up or down to adjust its order of visibility. To work with a specific layer, click on it to select it. At this point, you can enable the Move tool to move and resize it, or use the Brush tools on the left. For example, you can use the Smudge tool to drag and move pixels around, or switch to the Sponge tool to adjust the color saturation by increasing or decreasing it. The Dodge and Burn tools add or remove brightness where you brush. On the Draw section, enable the Brush or the Pencil tool for freehand drawing. Adjust brush size and color from the options at the bottom. Use the Eraser tool to remove unwanted pixels or extract backgrounds detected with Background Eraser tool. You can also cut and paste one image onto another. Just select the entire image and then press Ctrl or Command and X to cut, and Ctrl or Command and V to paste it on the second image. The pasted element will appear as a new independent layer. If you cut and paste within the same image, the pasted element appears as a new layer but leaves a blank spot in the original image. To avoid this, switch to the Guided Workspace and go to Basics, then select Move and Scale Object. By following the step-by-step instructions, this feature lets you cut and move with automatic refill on the original image. When you're ready to save, go to File and then select Save As. To save your modifications and layers for future editing, save as PSD. To render the image, choose JPEG or a PNG format if you also need to save any transparency. Hey, thanks again for watching our tutorial. We hope you learned something new about Photoshop Elements 2025. And don't forget to visit our website or our YouTube channel where you'll find more tutorials on your favorite softwares. See you next time.